We're here today to talk a little bit about the brown recluse spider, probably the most misunderstood arachnid on the planet. I have several different kinds of spiders in front of me that are often mistaken for the brown recluse, but the brown recluse himself, there are just so many myths about it that people are very afraid, probably more afraid of this spider than any other spider in the United States. But probably all the things you believe about the brown recluse that are fact are actually probably misconceptions. So let's talk about a few of those. Most people think that anytime somebody gets bitten by a fiddleback, also known as the brown recluse, that they will get a big dead spot, flesh rotting sore. That actually is a very rare response. Sometimes people get a swelling, sometimes people get a little bit of a fever, but the actual dead spot of skin only happens in 1 out of 10 people. Sometimes, and this is more serious, people will actually get a systemic response. That only happens about 1% of the time, but that's when you really need to talk to a doctor and see if you can get treatment for that. So let's look at some of these spiders really quick. Three brown spiders. Which one is the fiddleback? The one in the center, which actually has the marking near the eyes that looks like a guitar shape. The reason that a misdiagnosis or the misconceptions about the brown recluse are so important to understand is that if you have something happening to your body and you take it to a doctor and they misdiagnose this, they could be missing something more important. Skin lesions can be caused by leishmaniasis, lymphoma, infections, all these things which could be much more serious than a brown recluse bite. And if you ignore those, they can lead to serious medical issues. Now, a brown recluse bite is very common, probably. Most people have them in their homes. Brown recluses are found in Oklahoma, especially in places with lots of clutter. Attics, boxes, garages, you'll find numerous brown recluses, but they're very reclusive. They don't like people. And they're actually small spiders with very small fangs. The most common way that people get bitten is by laying their clothes on the floor. A spider will move into their clothes, which are warm and smelly at night. And then when people put those clothes or shoes on in the morning, they'll end up with a bite. The spider is so small and his fangs are so small that he actually needs the shirt or the pair of pants to push against to actually penetrate our skin and get an envenomation. So the most common places to get bitten are the legs, the arms, and the torso, more so than the hands or even the feet. If you have a bite and you develop the necrosis, the dead skin cells in that area, if it gets pussy, that is not a brown recluse bite. Brown recluse bites actually cave in, get white, and may take many weeks for the rot to develop. If a sore gets pussy and oozes, that's an indication of infection. Bacterial, fungal, microbial, virus infection, and you definitely need to seek medical attention to get antibiotics and hydrocortisone to treat those. While there are all these misconceptions and misunderstandings about this small spider, the population of humans have grown very fearful. In response to that, one of our leading arachnologists in the United States has responded with a book just this year written exclusively about the brown recluse. His name is Richard Vetter, and he's a retired professional arachnologist who has spent over 2 decades studying just this animal and collecting all sorts of scientific data regarding its dangerousness or not dangerousness, its life cycle, where it's found, its habitat, and just about anything else that you could imagine about this small spider. The book that he wrote is called The Brown Recluse by Richard Vedder, and it's produced from Cornell University. And it's taking 20 years of data and all the science that we could find about this animal and putting it into a book that's very easy for everyday people to read. It's intended for the general population more so than the scientific community. And his target is really for people to understand more about this spider, and specifically reaching out to medical practitioners who often make the mistake of diagnosing a spider bite when they might be looking at something else that needs a different and a more serious kind of treatment. 80% of bites are misdiagnosed as a spider bite when they could be gangrene or leishmaniasis or diabetic ulcers. There are any number of other things that can happen to your skin aside from a spider bite. So remember, when it comes to the brown recluse, only about 1 out of every 10 people has any kind of serious reaction, including that skin sore. Only 1% of people who are bitten have the systemic all over body response that can make you very sick. But so far, in all the documentation from 150 years of medical research, there has never been a documented death from the fiddleback, from the brown recluse spider, in the United States. Yes, you want to treat a bite, even if you think it's a bite and might be an infection, you want to go to the doctor and seek treatment. But you don't have to fear that this little tiny brown reclusive spider is going to mean death for your children, your pets, or yourself. They're actually very harmless, and if you want to treat them, the best thing to do is to bring in a professional to treat your house and then maintain with flat paper, inexpensive sticky traps to keep a check on the population in your house.
We hope you enjoyed this video. It's part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on our OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.